Distributed Database System, presented by Rupali Banerjee. Today our topic is Validation-Based Protocol. Validation-Based Protocol in DBMS is a type of concurrency control technique that works on the validation rules and timestamps. It is also known as the Optimistic Concurrency Control Technique. The protocol associated with three phases for managing concurrent transactions. Phases are read phase, validation phase, and write phase. The optimistic approach of the protocol assumes less interference among concurrent transactions. Hence, there is no checking process happening while the transactions are executed. Validation-based protocol is also called optimistic concurrency control technique. This protocol has three phases. They are, first one is read phase. In this phase, say there was one transaction TI, that transaction reads the value of various data items and stored them in temporary local variable of TI, that is temporary local buffer. So it does not update actual database. Our next phase is validation phase. Here transaction TI perform validation test whether it can copy value of its local variable to the database. Checking is performed to make sure that there is no violation of serializability when the transaction updates are applied to the database. So here, before updation, serializability will be checked. So what is serializability? We already learned serializability is a concurrency scheme where the concurrent transaction is equivalent to one that executes the transaction serially. So here checking is performed to make sure whether serializability is maintained or not. If serializability is maintained, then updates are applied to the database. And our last phase is write phase. Here, after validation of TI, the temporary results are written to the database. That is, system applies actual update to the database. To perform validation test, we need to know when the various phases of transaction TI took place. So, we shall therefore associate three different timestamps with transaction TI. There are three different timestamps. First one is start TI. It is the time when TI started its execution. Validation TI, it is the time when TI just finished its read phase and begin its validation phase. And finish TI, it is the time when TI end its all writing operations in the database under write phase. We determine the serializability order by timestamp ordering technique using the value of timestamp validation TI. So, we can say that validation TI is actually timestamp of TI. Validation test. The validation test for transaction TJ requires that for all transaction TI with timestamp of TI less than timestamp of TJ, if one of the following conditions hold. See the conditions. First one is finish TI less than start TJ. Means finish timestamp of TI is less than start timestamp of TJ. So, before starting of TJ transaction, TI's transaction finishes its execution. So, since TI finished before TJ started, hence always serializability is maintained. Next condition is finish TI less than validation TJ. This means after writing operations of TI, validation of TJ is started. So, this ensures actual write by TI and TJ will not overlap. And the last condition is validation TI less than validation TJ. Means, it ensures that TI has completed read phase before TJ completed read phase. We will take one example. Then this thing will be more clear for you. Take one example. These are the conditions for validation test we already learned. There are two transactions, TI and TJ. Now we have to check these conditions. Check the first one. Finish timestamp of TI is less than start timestamp of TJ. But see here, before TI finishes its execution, TJ started. So we can't say that finish TI is less than start TJ. Here, start TJ is less than finish TI. So this condition is false. Take the second one. And the second condition is finish TI is less than validation TJ. So finish timestamp of TI is less than validation timestamp of TJ. Yes, it is true. And the third one is validation TI is less than validation TJ. Yes, validation timestamp of TI is less than validation timestamp of TJ. First TI validate itself and then TJ validate itself. So this condition is also true. So it completes the concurrent transaction scenario with validation based protocol in DBMS. Advantages: avoid cascading rollbacks. These validation based scheme avoid cascading rollbacks. Why? Since the final write operation to the database are performed only after the transaction passes the validation phase. So after validation phase, final writing is done. Now in the meantime, if the transaction fails, then no updation operation is performed in the database. So no dirty read will happen. Hence, possibilities of cascading rollback will be null. Second one is avoid deadlock. Since here a strict timestamping based technique is used to maintain the specific order of transaction. So timestamp is used here to maintain the order. Hence, deadlock is not possible in this scheme. Disadvantages: starvation. Starvation is the situation when a transaction has to wait for an indefinite period of time to acquire a lock. There might be a possibility of starvation for long-term transactions due to a sequence of conflicting short-term transactions that cause the repeated sequence of restart of the long-term transactions, so on and so forth. So these are your questions. Try to answer this question in the comment section. I am waiting for your reply. For getting more and more updates, please like, share and subscribe my channel. That's all for today. Thank you.